Hey, how y'all doing? My name is Jerome Hardaway, Executive Director of Vetsu Code, programmer and writer. I'm here today to teach you all how to get the software engineering job. Over the past 8 years, I've helped over 300 military spouses and veterans break into tech from non-computer science backgrounds. And with this course, I aim to help you do the same. We'll go over the three gatekeepers between you and your job. We'll also be talking about how to build a personal brand database, resume tips, building a rockstar GitHub profile, building your portfolio, and networking for tech newbies. I hope you leverage the things that are taught in this course so you can get the job that you've earned. This is our first user. This is the invisible user, the user that you're never gonna see, but you know they're there. They have been in HRAI, first gatekeeper that you're going to encounter, especially as a new dev, as a dev that hasn't had their first job. They're also gonna be the most difficult gatekeeper that you're gonna encounter because you don't have the advantage of having experience that can be looked at as, you know, hardcore, oh, this was a paid job, unless you're taking contract work or volunteer work that they're able to like actually track. The way that these systems look at it is that, you know, they're gonna be your hardest adversary, right? So AI has been increasingly integrated into HR operations in various aspects of resource HR management, right? A few types of AR tools that we're looking at today, and this day is also ATS, think of like workable, things of that nature, right? That handles the recruitment needs, that handles its primary purpose is to sort through like all your resumes, right? So there's like 10,000 resumes, it's reading the resumes, looking for the keywords, and you're like, oh, if you don't have these keywords, you're fired automatically, bam, you know, thank you. You know, I don't know if you've ever had this happen where you sent a resume in and then like almost immediately you've gotten an email that says thank you, but you're not what we're looking for. Like, wow, how did you read that fast? They didn't. ATS did, right? Which is why one of the things that you need to be doing when you're working with, on your resumes, things like that, make sure that you have the keywords that are in these job requirements in your resumes. Because what's going to happen is when you don't have it, it quickly scans it. It's scanning for other years. It's scanning for those languages, for those tools. And the next thing you know, you're either in or you're out quickly, right? Your goal is to try to bypass that system. Hiring recruiter, the second gatekeeper, second user, they play a crucial role as a bridge between the company and the candidate. If you're applying for a software engineering role, the recruiter will be your primary point of contact in the initial point of process. They are the first person that you will interact with, and that makes them one of the most important people. At my current role at Microsoft, we have a gotcha person, right? Which is non-technical, but you will interact with that based upon how you interact with this person. It may be the fail or pass of whether you get to your job, whether you get the job, right? It's our way of ensuring that our diversity and inclusion values are met by seeing how you treat people who may be different from you. So like I said, hiring recruiters, they're gonna be your initial contact. Good sign, right? You want to build rapport with your hiring recruiter, right? This person's gonna go to bat for you. They want to see you win. They are different from every other gatekeeper on this. They need you to win. They want to, because guess what? No one wants to be, you know, tied up in the hiring process for long, right? So once you reach this person's whole job is to make sure you look good, right? Your job is to make it look easy. Right? When they ask you for your resume, already have a resume built out, that resumes are your highlight reel. They're your snapshot. They're not meant to be super long. It's meant to have just the good stuff and move on with your life, right? Your portfolio, that is your Picasso. Make sure that, you know, the above the fold content is nice. It's processing fast. We have an entire checklist. We're gonna go through towards the later. So, and I also added it as a resource. So you don't even have to go and wait for me to tell you that there's 20, 30 pieces of the checklist that I, you know, for your portfolio that I want to make sure you're doing. But those are the two rules that I always follow. Resume is a snapshot, portfolio is your Picasso. So I view the developer team, the devs, as the, they are the final boss and gatekeeping, right? If you've met them, or you're meeting them, it's a good thing, but it's gonna be a stressful thing at the same time, right? Now, here is one of those things where if you've done your portfolio right, you have solved 50% of your problem with you, if you've done your portfolio right. Because you want a portfolio that is what I like to call front-loaded, as in you want to answer so many questions about yourself prior to them meeting you that they don't have any questions asking, or you know, or you want to have them, you know, they're thinking about the questions to ask you about the thing that you already know, right? So that's how you want to be able to, it's almost like, it's exactly like PSYOPs. How we do in the military is what, with psychological operations, is that we want the user, the person that we're speaking to ask us or talk to us about the things that we're already experts in, that we have, may have more expertise than them, right? So we're guiding, we're using our resources, such as our portfolio and our resume and the work that we've done to guide them towards that direction so that it builds more interest in us and makes the interview easier for us, right? So that is what you have to do with your developer team, right? Such things like we've spoken earlier, you wanna talk as if you're already on the team. The rule of thumb that I use with my troops is that you want to pass what I like to call the 5 p.m. rule, which means you want to be the person that after 5 p.m. on Friday, they do not want to throw you out of a window. They don't want to like quickly get your new computer that they just sent you and like revoke your access after 5 p.m. on a Friday, right? That's your goal. How do we do this? We answer our questions clearly. We make sure we study the resources, study for the interview. We make sure that we ask before the interview, like who's all on the dev team, so that way you can research them because you may have something that you find interesting of them. So you can have these conversations. You want them to feel as if you're already on the dev team. So this is my brand database. I have two sections, my brag document and my biography. So my biography, I have the picture that I use for everything. Except, of course, Vetsuit Frontend Masters, they decided to use like their own photo of me. Boo. Right? I have this very, very long biography that's intentional. So that way I can chop it up based upon as needed. Like, hey, if I want to go to ChatGPT and like, hey, can you make this like the size of a tweet? And they were like, okay, cool, sure, here you go, right? I have my preferred web font and colors in here. Preferred web font is Gotham, that became famous during Barack Obama first campaign. So that's been my favorite one. These three colors, we call them the hash flag colors. So F6 three times, hash flag white, hash flag blue, and hash flag red. So, got a little, bam, right there. That's shareable, and my brag document. How the brag document is, I, of course, start out with here, and I make sure every link has its own, like, home for each one. So my projects all have a link, my blogs all have a link, everything I've written has a link, every article I've been on has a link. I just keep this document going, so that way everyone I have this I can grab from, what regardless of where I'm planning on going to, right? This is 8 years of work. One day you're gonna be there. Like, I started off with nothing, just like y'all. So as a developer, your GitHub profile is essential to your professional brand, right? The harsh reality is that even the person that doesn't know anything about GitHub, i.e. the user number two, is gonna go there, right? And they're gonna judge you based upon your the most arbitrary things on your GitHub. Hey, guess what? I don't see a user image. Hey, I don't see a GitHub profile readme. I don't see any pinned projects. I don't see anything that showcases that you're native to this platform, right? And this person doesn't write code at all, right? The AI, ATS systems, the chatbots, the things that are gonna be checked, the links that are the HR AI tools that check the links and then, you know, can actually pick up, you know, how many repos do you have and does this specialized repo exist and things like that. they're going to judge you too, right? You're going to get flagged for those things. So you have to pay special attention. Like, as a programmer, we, you know, we're told that the resume is the first, like the first thing that people are going to build your, build an opinion about you. For me, I kind of find it's like, it's going to be the third. The first thing that people tend to build a like opinion about you is your portfolio. I mean, is your GitHub profile. That's what I've seen. Like, I build totally biased. I will formulate half of my opinion on a programmer based upon what I see on their GitHub, like immediately, right? When applying for jobs to employers, they often review GitHub, talk about that. So let's look at what I view, starting with my own, and then I'll move over to someone else's, as a at least a strong professional, you know, profile, right? So this is my profile. Like, this is my legit, this is me. Who I am, like, that's my face right there. Hi, I'm Jerome, executive director of Etsu Code. I have a link here from a Vercel project that shows how many times people have looked at my profile. I've also been pulling another link from this. If you were to go here and look at the raw, I'm pulling these links in where I am seeing, where I've attached them to my GitHub, so that way you can see these a GitHub, like the GitHub Trophy Vercel app with my username, as well as the label for my profile views. Both of those are separate projects that I'm pulling in that are connected to my GitHub app so that people can see what I've done in these, right? So here I am. I have, hey, I jumped up. A lot of y'all looking, okay. No, you know, no stress. Multi-language. I guess there might be some like PHP still in there. Followers, I'm a hyper celebrity. I don't know what that means in GitHub land. Repositories, issues, pull requests, commits, reviews, and stars. So this is all like the little trophies that they have out there on that API. I'm telling people, you know, what I'm working on, what I'm currently doing, currently recording front end masters, currently learning Azure AI services, AWS Amplify, Python. I'm recording nothing next because I am going to be on potty training duty starting next week with my one-year-old. I'm always looking for help with Etsu Code. The things that that people should ask me about is Git, React, Next.js, AI tools, and getting a software engineering job, which you all are here for. Yay, right? So connect with me. I tend to leave blank because 8 billion people that will reach out to me in 8 billion ways all the time. Like, I have like 40 messages right now on LinkedIn alone because of this. So I'm like, you'll figure out how to find me. I don't have to say this. Languages and tools. These are languages and tools that I still use to this day, either teaching or at work. So that's why they're all on here. And the only reason Ruby on Rails and SAS are on here is because I teach, I use it. PHP probably should get off there because I don't want to get paid for it. Postgres, MySQL, if that, that's a great hardware tool that I've used for like the lights at my house. Here I have most used languages. Which is Java, like, so 9% of my projects of my code is PHP. So it is still there somewhere. I haven't gotten rid of all of it. Ruby on Rails, CSS, JavaScript, and HTML. So, I mean, maybe if I was using, like, those ratings that you're all talking about, say how much of each language I have written, that would make sense. But do that. Just don't rate yourself on your performance on your own code, on your resumes or your portfolios. My GitHub stats and my total contributions. That's all a part of a special profile, a special README called your profile README. So for mine, it's Jerome Hardaway / Jerome Hardaway. For yours, it will be your GitHub name / your GitHub name.